Hello everyone, in this session we will see how to form the YBUS matrix by using inspection method. Let us see the points to be considered. Self-admittance. In the last lecture, I have told you the self-admittance is nothing but the sum of the admittances connected to a particular node or bus, and the mutual admittance will be the negated value of the admittance connected between the particular nodes. So now let us see what are the points that here we have mentioned. The first point is the each diagonal term y suffix pp is called the self-admittance of node p. That is what we have taken. If it is y11, it refers to the self-admittance of node 1. If it is y22, that refers to the self-admittance of the node 2. In a general way, P refers to any bus that can be a first bus, second or nth bus also. The second point is the self-admittance we will get by taking the algebraic sum of the admittances connected to particular node. Line charging admittances or shunt admittances, that also to be considered into the calculations. Coming to the mutual admittance, the each off-diagonal element, that is YPQ, will be the representation for the mutual admittance between any nodes P and Q, and that value will be equal to the negative value of the admittances connected between these two nodes. So they have given sum of the admittances connected between these two. Sometimes between the two nodes, if there are two transmission lines are connected between the two nodes, means we need to add these two admittances with a negative sign. And also further we have a condition where YPQ will be equal to YQP. Now let us see one example how to form the YBUS by using inspection method. Form the bus admittance matrix for the system given below. Neglect the line charging admittance of the bus. So here we have considered three buses and three transmission lines. Here the unit is Siemens or the most. The given values are the admittance value. This is the Y12 value because it is connected between the 1 and 2, and this is Y13 value which is connected between first bus and third bus. It is connected between 2 and 3. This is Y23. So we know Y12 is equal to Y21 and Y13 is equal to Y31 and Y23 will be equal to Y32. Let us form the YBUS matrix. We know the YBUS dimension will be number of buses to the number of buses. So here we are considering all the buses as a actual buses. There is no reference bus. So now we can form the YBUS matrix between the number of buses to the number of buses. Okay, you can check the corresponding components here. Now let us fill the values Y11, 1213, Y212 and 31233. So now if you see the diagonal component values, all the diagonal values are the self-admittance values, remaining values are the mutual admittance values. Getting the mutual admittance value is very simple. You just see the network. Whatever value is connected between the respective nodes, the negative value of that will be equal to the mutual component of the YBUS matrix. The self-admittance will be the sum of the admittances connected to the bus. In this problem, they have not given any shunt admittances. Problem has become even more simple. The Y11 value will be sum of these two values. This is Y12 and this is Y13 and this is Y23. So Y12 plus Y13 will be equal to Y11, that is -J1 -J2 will be the -J3. Then Y12 will be equal to -Y12. Y12 is equal to -J1 more, then -Y12 will be J1 more. Next, Y13 will be equal to, between 1 and 3 we have -J2, minus of -J2 will be +J2. Now similarly, Y12 value will be equal to Y21. These two values will be equal to each other. So whatever value here we have, the same value will come here, J1. Then J22 value will be sum of the admittances connected to this second bus. So this admittance is connected, two lines are connected. Sum of these two will be -J4. Now Y23 value will be -Y23, minus of this value, that will be J3. Now Y31 will be minus of the admittance connected between 3 and 1. And one more thing, you know, y13 will be equal to y31. So y31 value also will be equal to j2. And coming to y32 will be equal to y23. So that is j3. And y33 value is equal to sum of the admittances connected to the third bus. That is minus j2 minus j3, which is equal to minus j5. So this is how we have to form the bus admittance matrix using the inspection method. So let us see one more example. Form the Y-bus matrix for the system given below. So we have given 4 buses. The line connected between the 1 and 2 is having impedance J0.2 ohms. And Z13 is equal to J0.3. And Z23 is equal to J0.1. And Z34 and 43 both are equal to J0.4. And we have Z10 which is equal to J0.6. And Z20 equal to J0.6. And Z30 is equal to J0.8. So in this problem, we have a shunt admittance values also. So whatever it is, the procedural details are same. Okay. If you are finding the self admittances, add all the admittances connected to the particular bus. If you are finding the off diagonal element, take the negative value of the admittance or impedance connected between the respective nodes. The given problem is formation of the Y bus matrix, but the given values are the impedance values. First, you people should check that one. If they are specifying the given values are the admittance values, then only we have to take these values as a admittance values. If they are not telling anything, okay, simply they have given the value J0.2, okay, they have not mentioned whether it is an impedance or admittance value, means by default we have to consider this as a impedance value, not the admittance value. If they tell that the given values are the admittance values, or if they give the unit as a Siemen or mho like this, then you can say that it is a admittance value. Now in this problem, the given values are in the impedance form. So first we need to convert the given impedance values to the admittance values. Then you apply the points to get the Y-bus matrix. So we know the admittance will be equal to the reciprocal of the impedance. You just take the corresponding values, means the Y10 will be equal to 1 by Z10, then Y20 will be equal to 1 by Z20, then Y30 equal to 1 by Z30. Similarly, the Y values will be the reciprocal of the corresponding Z values. So let us find all the admittance values for the given impedance values of the lines. Y10 equal to 1 by Z10, which is given as a 1 by J0.6, that is equal to minus J1.67. Then Y20 equal to 1 by Z20, that also will be the same. And Y30 is equal to 1 by J0.8, which is equal to minus J1.25 mho. Now similarly, Y12, Y13 and Y23. Y34 values we have determined. So these are the corresponding admittance values for the given impedance. Now let us replace all the impedance values in the above network by the admittance values. Now if you replace all the impedance by admittance values, so this is the corresponding network in terms of the admittance. Now directly by looking at the network, we can form the Y-bus matrix. So let us form the Y-bus. So how many buses are here? We have 4 buses. So the Y-bus matrix will be 4 by 4 matrix. And Y11 will be sum of the admittances connected to the first bus. So the sum of the admittances connected, this admittance, this value and this value. Okay, all the 3 lines are connected to the first node. So you will add all the 3 values, minus J1.67, minus J5 and minus J3.3. So altogether if you add, you will get minus J10 mho. And coming to the 12, okay. So if you have any confusion, you just mark the bus numbers here, 1, 2, 3, 4. and here also you mark it as a 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, now you can start filling. It is Y12. Y12 will be minus J5 minus of minus. Okay, that will become plus J5, not minus. And Y13 will be equal to minus J3.33. That will become plus J3.33. And Y14, we don't have any connection between the 1 and 4. That will be equal to 0. Now coming to the 2,1, so 1,2 will be equal to 2,1, which is equal to plus J5, and Y22, add all the shunt admittances connected to the second bus. So this is connected and this is connected and this also is connected. That is minus J5, minus J1.67 and minus J10 will give us minus J16.67. And coming to the 2,3, 2,3 value is minus J10, minus of minus will become plus J10. And Y24, is there any connection between second bus and fourth bus? No, we don't have any direct connection between these two, so that will be 0. Now Y13 will be equal to 31, that I can fill directly, J3.33. And Y32, the 2,3 value is equal to J10, so the Y32 also will be equal to J10. Y33, so look at the third bus. So the sum of the admittances connected to the third bus, we have a 4 lines connected. You have to add this one, this and this value. All together we have to add minus J10, minus J3.33, minus J2.5, minus J1.25. If you add all these shunt admittances with respect to this third bus, we will get Y33. So that will be equal to minus J17.08. Now coming to the 3,4. So is there any line connected between 3 and 4? Yes, we have. Okay, we have a minus J2.5, but we have to take the negative value of the value connected between the line. So this will become 2.5J. Now coming to the 4,1. So 4,1 will be equal to 1,4, that is 0. 4,2 will be equal to 2,4. 2,4 value, again it is 0. And 4,3 value will be equal to 3,4, which is a J2.5. And 4,4 value. So let us see the sum of the admittances connected to the fourth bus. We have only one transmission line connected to this. That will be equal to minus J2.5. So it is very, very simple. At the same time, it is the most important with refer to the load flow studies. So I hope it is clear how to form the Y bus by using the inspection method. Thank you.